Hello, bit of a hasty one. I'm going to throw this together. I'm going to start by just reading a letter that I've sent off to, an email to the Home Office. By the way, public.inquiries@homeoffice.gov.uk. I urge as many of you as possible, please, to do the same. Dear sirs, I write as a concerned citizen about the violence that I've witnessed over the last couple of weeks to MEP candidates. I'm sure you're aware that a man is currently serving a month-long jail sentence for egging Jeremy Corbyn. See link below. I've copied links to prove, you know, back up these points. I believe strongly that violence in any form is unacceptable, and I'm sure you agree with me. I also feel that when those who are politically opposed to you are violently attacked, that the same standard of law enforcement is appropriate. I also feel that MPs shouldn't condone and or openly encourage said violence. Please let me know if you agree with that point. And I've shared a link to a Twitter link, Johnny Mercer UK, who put a very, very sarcastic comment about sharing milkshakes with people if they want to sit down instead of having a chat and a coffee, chat and a milkshake with a little winky emoji. Yeah, very funny, mate. The next link is one of many from the media either laughing or encouraging violence, and I've just put one that's, you know, just celebrating it. Take your pick, guys. There are many. Many in the media are saying that it's just milkshake. Well, that was just an egg. So please check the double standards there. Also, there has also been physical violence towards Carl Benjamin, MEP candidate for UKIP South West Region, and towards Tommy Robinson, aka Stephen Lennon. But the milkshake incidents seem to be really funny to MPs and the media. I now move to the horrific scenes of Oldham from a couple of days ago, where the police gave an escort to a group of hundreds of angry masked Muslim men from the Muslim Defence League. These men organised this attack on social media, and for some reason there is no pressure on Facebook to ban these accounts. I will repeat, and I just put in capitals, the police gave escort to a gang of hundreds of masked Muslim men to a political rally organised purposely away from any Muslim area. Please explain why the police would do that. Of course the Muslim men started attacking the crowd, consisting of men, women and children, who would likely be terrified. Bricks, bottles and even scissors were thrown. Please watch the link below, for example. I've put a link to a video showing it. These horrific scenes of very real and dangerous violence has been encouraged in the media and by politicians, and the police have refused to take action. If on the first days of campaigning the police had actually done their job and prosecuted the young man who aggressively threw milkshake in Tommy Robinson's face, then others would have been less likely to follow suit, wouldn't they? But effectively, you, the Home Office, are responsible for this escalation of violence, and now innocent people are being injured. I'm utterly ashamed of your non-action. And of course, the media are, as usual, reporting inaccurately of this horrific incident in Oldham and making it look as though Tommy thugs attacked the police. An outright lie. And I shared a link to The Independent, but take your pick again. I left a quote at the end from Mohandas Gandhi. First they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they will fight you, and then you win. And I desperately hoping this is going to play out that way. I would very much like to hear from you with your view on this extremely concerning violence that has been openly encouraged by the British police force, parliament and media, who clearly all work together. Yours sincerely, enough, just put my name. It's horrific, and now it's clearly, it's not just funny, it's not just milkshakes. And I did a video on this last week or week before, just saying that, you know, this will escalate. And lo and behold, it's escalated. People are getting hurt. Children are having to be either locked in their homes or driven away in vans with police escort from violent thugs. And if it wasn't Muslims doing the violence, the media would be clearly condemning them. But because they Muslims, they protected. They can't be wrong. They're fascist. They're far right. The media should be lapping this up because far right fascist thugs are attacking children. My God, what is wrong? Anyway, so I also shared that letter to my MP, pathetic Dr. Liam Fox, who will do absolutely nothing, and his Douglas Ione, I think his name is, his mate will just give me some bullshit answer. one quick shout out to the incredible Simon, the Reverend Simon Sideways. Well done, mate. Honestly, I've been watching your dedication to this and your support, and I know you've been milkshaked a few times, and I've seen you get punched and kicked and had your tires slashed and had shit thrown at you, and unbelievable, mate. My hat goes off to you. You got a mention on, I think it was the Britisher and Politico. You got a mention on the Britisher as well. Well done, guys. I wanted to talk about how watching the scenes yesterday made me feel, and I am a total wuss, least violent person you'll ever meet. Anyone that knows me will back that up. Okay, it ain't my bag at all. Call me a coward, whatever, I don't really mind. I felt violent. I was watching it and I felt violent. That passed. I'm furious, I'm angry, and I'm just desperately concerned that people that are less pacifistic, if that's a word, than I will no doubt feel that they've probably got nowhere else to turn now other than violence, because when everyone in the state is against you and lying about you and accusing you of doing what is being done to you, they're going to feel hopeless. And I just want to, this is the, I suppose, the last gasp hope that you've got to vote. My God, this whole I'd never vote thing, it's never been, and it might be too late for you to apply now, but if you've got the form and you're umming and erring on it, my God, vote. And please, if you are, you know, I'm a UKIP guy, so I'm saying vote UKIP, but if I was in the Northwest, if you're there, put it in for Tommy. Let them see that it backfire on them. Let all of them, the state they're, and the media, they're all in it together. Let them see it blow up in their face. You have to. And again, I did a video a couple of days ago about not spoiling your ballot box, your ballot paper. Please, please, just withhold any urge you've got to write obscenities or anything like that on there, or Brexit or anything like that. Just put a cross in the box. And again, people advise me, take a black ballpoint pen yourself. Don't do it with the pencil they give you, because there could be, I'm not saying this, it's unlikely that it'll be organised, but there could be the odd one here or there that are particularly civil service types that particularly hate UKIP and might rub off your vote. Who knows? I would just say it's unlikely, but do that with a biro. Anyone that wants to go along and attend an account, you can, but you have to apply. You can ring up your local council and ask them where it's being held. My one's going to be held at the Hutton Moor Leisure Centre in Weston-super-Mare. I might be a bit too late. I can write to, you can get an email address to write to and ask them if your name can be added to the list to go and watch. Because what you can do then is you can stand in front of them when they're counting. You can't use your phone or anything like that, but you can stand and you can watch and you can observe them counting. And that's really helpful, because they know people are watching them. They're less likely to put your thing in the wrong pile. I'm pretty much run out of things to say now. Please, anyone that feels that urge to be violent, please hold that in check, because it will just get used against you, used against this movement. And, you know, violence is only there for when you're being attacked, or when your family, loved ones, what have you, are being attacked. That's it, really. Fingers crossed that we send a shockwave through them. And they then realise that no matter what they do, the dirtier they get, the more it blows up in their face. Anyway, see you in the next one. Bye.